My mother died fairly recently, and I had some items of hers left in a will. Those items each had a story from my mother, or a story that related to me and my relationship with her, really. I was really quite shocked, I think, to know that the British had camps where Polish people had to live. It's one of those things that's not covered by any history programs or programs about the war. So that was a, you know, totally unique, something that just hadn't heard of before.
I think it has a really unique tone and quality to it. It's very reflective. But being in it, it's a very strange experience because it is so minimal. The movement that I do is hardly anything at all, and there are huge, you know, moments of stillness, and I suppose on a personal level it is quite reflective for me as an actor. I suppose in that control it heightens the emotion even more, which, yeah, I think the whole performance really captures that sort of wanting to express all this emotion but not quite being able to.
I did remember a few things, but not everything. But I've been twice. The first time I was about 3 days, and I have to admit, I was very upset.
Yeah.
The second time I went with friends, and we just enjoyed it.
Everyone has a story. Mm-hmm. Yes. They went across, especially how long they waited at the borders, where they searched. As I said, my first trip was in 1960. But both the houses were still there. But the second house, I didn't dare to go into them. But the second house, I didn't want to tell my father because he told me exactly what the garden looked like. And I've got some old photographs of the family in the garden. Half of that was taken away. A great big factory is built at the back. So
we're looking for our roots. We're looking for friends. Looking for family. Because a lot of them died, a lot of them vanished, all sorts of things happened.
Documents also, a lot of documents were destroyed.
Today I've come all the way from Manchester for this performance because I feel really passionate about what these people went through and getting the word out so that more people know about it. So I thought it was really, you know, really well made, the way the interview and the objects sort of, you know, gel together and triggered all these memories for this lady. It's a similar sort of thing that I can relate to, because when my mother died 5 years ago, I was looking through her photographs and documents, and then having lots of questions in my mind that I hadn't really thought of asking her before.
She's captured her yes. mother's story yes. for everybody to see. Yes. Bilingual, in Polish and English, our museum also is. Yes. We're trying to do it, you know, so that everybody can read and understand and see what's going. This is fantastic. This is what I wanted, and I can't do that with my family. So I'm determined now to reach out to other people yes. to get these stories. Yeah.